excited. I've never seen more energy than I do in our party right now. I see college kids are out there getting signatures, getting involved with the process. I see people all the time that have never gone out and worked campaigns before. And we're out there. And I think Donald Trump has been so hard for so many of us, but I really think this is the moment for our entire country that we really stand up and we say, we've had enough. And I just really want to take a second and recognize that. We are just really doing well. So I am one of the many women that was kind of devastated on election night and decided I had to do something. And I want to tell you a little bit about my story. I'd done enough work for the Hillary Clinton campaign that I was actually at her private party on election night. I was about 20 feet from where I expected her to accept the presidency. And I have to tell you, that was a hard night for a lot of us in that room. You know, and I got on the train home, and I was on my way back to the software engineering company that I founded, and I knew that I had to get involved. I knew that I had to do more. And that's why I decided to run for United States Congress this year against Stephen Lynch. You know, for me, I think the issues of me versus Lynch are very, very straightforward. I am a fighter. There is no one that knows me that will tell you that Breonna Boone is not a fighter. And I do feel, in my opinion, that when it comes to the hardcore Democratic issues, Stephen Lynch just hasn't been there fighting for us the way that he can. This is a man that voted against Obamacare. This is a man that took 9 days to issue a statement on the Muslim ban. This is a man that just is really consistently not there on wealth inequality and LGBT rights and women's equality as well. So I want to tell you, you know, every politician can tell you what positions they take. I want to give you a little bit of my story and just tell you what I've done in my career and why I would hope this would give trust with everyone in this room and asking for your vote. In 2014, the technology industry was really falling apart. We didn't have a name for them at this point, but you know them as the alt-right. It was the proto-alt-right, and they found a formula to target women in the technology industry that were doing things they didn't like. Speaking up for equality, asking for women to be paid fairly. And what the alt-right found is a playbook to run against women. And what they would do is they would find us, and they would go through our entire past, and they would find something to take out of context and attack us with. Maybe an article you had written, a job you'd have, something. And they would run the Steve Bannon playbook on us. What happened with this is they've gone through so many women in engineering and have run us out of the field with death threats, rape threats, threatening to murder our children, this extreme online harassment. And this was Steve Bannon and the alt-right that eventually brought this after me. For me standing up for that, you know, it would have been so much easier to back down and to say, you know what, I'm gonna go back to my studio, I'm gonna make some money, I'm gonna enjoy my career. But I never ever did that. And because of that, I ended up getting so many further death threats and rape threats sent to me. They actually made a Law and Order episode about it. There's actually an episode of The Internet Ruined My Life, another one that they did about this. There have been 6 documentaries about the extreme threats on my life and the rape threats that I got and still get to this day. The alt-right was sitting outside of my house just a few nights ago with the camera, taking pictures of Frank and I through the window just to say, you know what, Breonna, we know where you live. And they emailed that to me. I have never backed down from any of that because if I did, I could not live with myself. I am a fighter. I spent my entire career fighting for women in engineering. And I will fight just as hard for the people in this room. Now, I just want to say one more thing about me before my time is up. Yeah, I didn't go to Harvard. I didn't go to the Ivy League. I'm a self-taught engineer. I grew up in a poor city in a very poor state. So when it comes to income inequality and underfunded public schools and underfunded public infrastructure, this is really personal to me. It's incredibly personal for me. And I think the core axis of what our party has got to think about is, does the Democratic Party stand with the corporations? Do we stand with the 1%? Or do we stand with the people that we are asking to support us and vote for us? So I hope when you see my name on that ballot, you will know, if you vote for me, I will fight for you. It's what I've done my entire career. Thank you very much.